Thank you for tuning into Cornerstone Abundant Life Church YouTube Ministry with Apostle Terry G. Simmons Sr. Please like, share, and subscribe to spread these powerful messages from God.
We thank God for our church anniversary. Like I told the church, it don't nobody else celebrate but us. Well, I'm not going to prolong, and I know the Super Bowl is in our heart today. So I'm not going to prolong us being the body of Christ and being caught on the Super Bowl and not on the Spirit of God. And I like sports too, but it shouldn't come before God. This is a Super Bowl. God has souped us up. But we're not going to belong. Thank God for everybody coming to celebrate with us. It shows me what the body feel about the body. It really shows. And I'm going to just help y'all. I didn't supposed to be the one speaking. We had a speaker, but he had a mercy. And so, rather than to call somebody and put somebody on the spot, the Lord told me to do it myself. Now, if some of y'all offended by that, bless you. You know, bless you. Because we shouldn't get offended by that. But anyway, I thank God got the right word for the house, for the whole house, not for Cornerstone. Because you can't get a word just for Cornerstone, and you can't get a word just for this person, that person. You had to really get something from God. 1 Peter, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 16th verse. I'm gonna get y'all out of it. But you know they got this, they said they got the two best quarterbacks. 1 Peter 4, verse 16. They said we got the best two quarterbacks playing today, the best QB. And when I was going before the Lord, he said, well, Terry, you getting the quarterback before both of them. And they ain't the best because they ain't passing the gospel. So I'm the best QB at this Super Bowl. And we didn't put our church anniversary on the Super Bowl. The Super Bowl joined up with us. If y'all know the sports, but people want me to change it, but change it for what? When God's supposed to be the first in our life. What I'm going to change for the Super Bowl for? But anyway, I see y'all got some sad looks on y'all face. I don't know what happened to the joy of the Lord, but it is my strength. It's my strength, so you know, whether how we look or how we feel, it shouldn't really matter. Because he said we should enter into his court with praise and thanksgiving. He said he inhabited the praise of his people. And we come in like we done been in church all day and like we ain't served that God that I'm talking about. He's still alive. I know he got the right word. And he got the right QB to pass this. In 1 Peter, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 16th verse, it says, yea, if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. For the time has come that the judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinners appear? Wherefore let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their soul to him is well doing, as unto us a faithful creator. Oh, Heavenly Father, in Jesus, I say right now, God, have your way in this service. Do whatever you're to do, God, but have free course. God, I ask that you anoint my eyes that I can see what the money spirit you desire for me to see. Anoint my ears that I can hear directly from heaven. But most of all, God, anoint my mouth that I will say nothing of myself, God, but all that you give me to say. God, but your servant has some else of you, that you anoint your people ears, that the way they came in this house, they won't leave that way. God, right now, send your Holy Ghost in this place to arrest the heal, to set free, to deliver. But most of all, have your way, God. And you say in your word that you be lifted up from the earth, you'll draw all men unto me. God, will come to lift up the name that's above every name. That cancer, sugar diabetes, had to come subject to it. Heartaches and heart pain had to come subject. God, we say right now, have your way with your servant. And we'll forever give you the praise. We'll give you the thanks. And so in Jesus' name we pray. And every heart can say, amen, amen, amen. And we can have our seat. And God has been better to me than I've been to myself. And the more and more, when I first got saved, a lot I didn't know about the gospel. I didn't know about God. And like I said, so many people had a form of godliness, but I didn't know the difference. So when I came to the church, we was professing that we were saved and holy. And more and more I started learning about God's word, I found out that a lot of people had a form of godliness. And we say a lot of things with our mouth, even the preachers. We say a lot of things with our mouth, but our heart be far from it. We constantly talk about the body of Christ as one, but we so separated in the body of Christ. Because every man exalt his denomination more than he exalt Christ. And that's why we are like we are today. We cannot live by this book that God has put before us. All us preach it, all us teach it, but when it comes to living it, we have a problem of finding out how to do it. Today God had me to bring a word to this place. It's time for the church to put up or shut up. Because we've been talking long enough. We've been preaching long enough, and we don't do none of it that we said. It's time for the church to put up or shut up. And if we ain't going to preach it and be a doer of it, shut up. From the pulpit to the door. If we ain't going to live holy and we ain't going to do what we tell our people to do, we need to put up or shut up. And I looked at the word put up or shut up. It said, if you saying someone should put up or shut up, you mean that they should either take action in order to do what they have been talking about or to stop talking about it. We constantly always saying what the body of Christ should be doing. And I'm finding out that most of the preachers won't do it themselves. You know, we encourage our people and we push our people to live right. And then we look at the preacher and the preacher ain't living right. I'm talking about it's time to put up or shut up. It's time for the church to put up or shut up. And that's why the world cannot come in the church, because when they see us, we booty shaking, we clubbing, we doing everything. We getting high, we buying drugs, we doing everything that the world do. And then we want the world to be saved. It's time for the church to put up or shut up. And so many times we are so caught up on ourselves that no one can see the glory of God, because it's about me. If I'm not preaching, I really don't want to hear nobody preaching. I really don't want to come. I really don't want to do nothing. But then, like he said, put up or shut up. And another one said, put your fists up to fight or back down. I believe I'm a contender for the gospel. It don't matter how no one feel, I'm going to stay with the book. You're not going to waver me from what God's word said. And we so caught up on the lit thing that, you know, I told the church, the men, I said, if I didn't know God's word and I looked at the church, I believe I would rather be a Muslim. I would rather be a Muslim, because the Muslims don't have a L.A. pastor. The Muslims don't have Atlanta pastor. The Muslim don't have Pensacola pastor. The Muslim is not trying to entertain what the world is doing. The Muslim is trying to keep focused on what they got going. And the church has deviated from what God has said. I'm talking about it's time to put up or shut up. We don't want to be holy no more. We want to be Baptist. We want to be Methodist. We want to be Amazon. And he said, be holy because your Lord God is holy. And I don't care what you, if you're Baptist, he said, be holy. I ain't got nothing against nobody being Baptist. I ain't got nothing against nobody being Catholic. But he still said, be ye holy for your Lord God is holy. But so many times we are going away from the word of God because we got our own thought pattern. And that's why church has got so mixed up, because somebody got mad with Zion, so they had a lit Zion. We all messed up because we ain't putting up or shutting up. We just got our own mind. But in Isaiah 57:21, it said, there is no peace, said my God, to the wicked. When you start changing God's word, he said, there is a judgment for you. Changing his word to fit what you want to. But the church, we so caught up in the organization. It's what my organization said. It's not what the words say. It's what I came up with and what this church said. We talking about mother with, in other words. It ain't God's word. It's just how we feel. But God told me in Ezekiel 33:7, he said, so thou, O son of man, O apostle Simon, I have called and set thee to be a watchman unto the Pensacola surrounding area. You know, I don't care how people feel. I have been called to be a watchman. He said, therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them for me. Don't nobody want to warn nobody no more about their wrongdoing. We let everything go on in the church and we endorse it. We endorse it because we scared the tithe's going to stop. Take your tithe, stick it up in your butt and go out the church. We got to do what the word said. He said, it's time for the church to put up or shut up. Ain't y'all tired of people telling you how holy they is? And then when you look around the corner, they creeping and doing everything they shouldn't be doing. He said, it's time to put up or shut up. And most of the time, what's killing us is the preacher. Because we fall out with each other. Maybe because we ain't got what the other one got. I don't care what no man got. It don't matter. I'm going to do what God has called me to do. And that's why Hebrews 2, I'm going to get you to the Super Bowl. I'm going to get you to the Super Bowl. And your favorite team might still lose. It don't make no difference. You ain't going to change that. The Super Bowl don't start by 6:30 or 5:45. But we got to be like the world. We got to have a Super Bowl party. You know, we just like the world. We for to be the church and for to be in another place. But we got to go home and get us some gumbo and some crackers and some cheese and all that and sit down and talk about the Super Bowl. Why we ain't talking about Jesus? It's him that was high and lifted up. It wasn't Cam Newton. It wasn't Peyton Manning. It wasn't none of them. It was God that was high and lifted up. He the one died for us. But we lift up the Super Bowl high and lifted up. But God told me to tell you today, it's time to put up or shut up. He said, that's what he told me. In Hebrews 2:1, he said, therefore we ought to give the most earnest heed. In other words, pay close attention to what God's saying. We ain't paying close attention no more. We trying to go to the internet like God ain't talking no more and get somebody else message. It's time to put up or shut up. You know, don't think God set you up and got you here because I'm preaching. Don't do that. That we start trying to size up. It don't matter to me who preach. If God giving a word, it could be a jackass. If he can go quote these scriptures, he's all right with me. Look at the church. Look at that. We ain't excited about the word of God. That's why the world ain't saved. It's because we don't know how to celebrate. Do you know everybody can get together and have a party? The drinkers, the drunkards at the liquor store, they can drink out the same bottle, but we can't. We want to be drinking out the same bottle, the same spirit, but we don't do that because that's not the way I preach. That's not the way I do it. But we all got different fingerprints. No matter how we feel, I'm celebrating. He said, put up or shut up. You mean that someone should say, take action on what they're saying. Ain't that bad? We won't take action on God's word. He said, contender for the faith. And we'll contend for everything else but the faith. Now, we'll preach hard if the church people stop paying money. We'll preach then. We'll preach. You can't get out the chair without them preaching. He said, but if you be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye. I don't mind. For the spirit of glory of God rests upon you. He said, on their part, he is evil spoken of. Huh? He's evil spoken, but on your behalf, he glorified. I'm glorifying him, Lord. I'm going to just stay with this book. And that's why God's trying to tell us something, but we don't want to take heed to it. He said, therefore, we ought to give the most earnest heed, huh, to the thing which you have heard, lest at any time we should slip. In other words, drift away from God. You know, the church don't drift away from God. When we used to be holy and we want to be right and we love God a lot, you know when we first got saved, we was coming to church shouting. Y'all know how we do. Now we coming to church like, child, here we go again. But you watch when y'all get on to the Super Bowl. You gonna talk more with that about the TV and the Super Bowl than you talk to anybody that you see that love God. Y'all know it. I hope I mess y'all Super Bowl up. I do, because Christ is saying if he be lifted up, not the Super Bowl, not Peyton Manning, not Cam Newton, he what the team is? Who, the Panther? Not that. He said, if I be lifted up. And that way he said in Leviticus 22 and 20, he said, but whosoever has a blemish, that shall ye be not offered, but it shall be not accepted for you. He mean, you can't come for God with them blemishes and stuff like that. Even though he did the same thing with them sacrifice back then, he don't want no blemish in your life. He don't want you loving nothing more than him. Y'all know where our mind at. Y'all know where most of our mind at. Super Bowl. Pastor, hurry up, I'm going to get through. But we talking about Christ. We talking about a spiritual bowl. We talking about, you know, they said SB for Super Bowl. Let's have a spiritual bowl. Let's us repent. You know, that's what I'm talking about. What's wrong with us? And that's why it said in Revelation 2 and 16, he said, repent, or else I will come unto thee quickly and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. In other words, God sent me to warn y'all. Y'all better stop putting all this garbage before God. And then trying to tell your member, I'm talking to a pastor. But you know, we scared to talk to each other. We used to preach to the people and not to us. But a lot of us need to be preached to. It's time to put up or shut up. Because God tells us in Revelation 2 and 4, he said, nevertheless, I have some words against thee. You don't left your first love. That Super Bowl Cam Newton didn't get y'all nailed down. Y'all can sit down and cry for the big baby. The big baby ain't gonna get y'all nailed down. He don't even know who you is. And you gonna go glorify him. His Jesus came down through 42 generations and died for us. And we gonna wanna sit on the TV for 4 hours from 2 o'clock to almost 7 o'clock watching them people on football. Loving it too. And here Jesus saying, what about me? Y'all don't stop loving me? What's wrong? And then he come back in Luke 6 and 46. I'm going to get y'all there. He said, why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the thing which I say? Why we keep calling him Lord, Lord, and won't do the thing that he say do? Huh? Why? He said, but in coming into 1 Peter 4 and 16, he said, I got a lot of time too, because one that much saying. Encourage me, Mac, encourage me. Well, how much? I don't wait by 2 minutes. Well, let me get out of there. He said, yea, if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on his behalf. If I'm going to suffer for all y'all falling out because of the truth, let me glorify on his behalf. Because one thing I know, the judgment is not going to begin at the liquor store. It's not going to begin at the crack house. It's going to begin while y'all in here playing, having a farm and a garden there, and got your mind on other things and not to glorify God. And God told me, you know, I try to change. You know, I got a red and black robe, and I tried to say, well, I'm going to wear the red and black robe because I want to match with the people. And God told me, then I tell you to wear black because I want them to be judged by what you say today. And I'm talking from the apostle all the way down to whatever it is at the bottom. You're going to be judged for not doing what God said. He said in Proverbs 21:16, he said, the man that wanders out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. When you wander away from God's word, wander away from his understanding, what you know is right, and now we letting anything go in the church. We don't care if a man assists it. All in the church acting like he the mother of the church. We don't care nothing. We ain't gonna send nothing. We ain't got no heart to send nothing. Huh? But we'll talk about somebody fornication. Get that sissy. Don't just get the fornicator. Don't just get the adulterer. Get you when you don't love right. Get you when you got to respect a person. I'm talking to a preacher. We need to stop having to respect a person and then preach it. And we can talk about the sister, and we can talk about fornication, we can talk about shacking. Don't you have no respect of person. You wander away from the truth, you wander away from the truth. He said in Luke 1:75, he said, in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. You can't do this part-time. I read a sign the other day, how a part-time Christian going to deal with a full-time devil. How you gonna deal with a full-time devil? He always doing what he's supposed to. It's the church that don't do what they supposed to. And look how we looking. We look like we don't swallow lemon. This the word. This supposed to be what you supposed to be excited about. Why are we looking so mad and so serious? I don't understand that. Judge them, God, judge them. Because we wrong for that. We wrong for that. This the word of God. He said he came down to follow to the generation and died for us. The word became flesh and dwelt among us. And now he left this manual with him for us. And now we hear in the manual what we preach. And we still look like, oh, what he talking about? I'm talking about what you preach. I'm talking about what you read. And that's why the Bible tells us, I'm finding this thing out about the church. He said in Amos 3:3, he said, can two walk together itself? That's the problem. We don't agree. We don't agree. If God is love, we ought to be loving everybody. We fall out with these little different because you said baptizing Jesus. I said baptizing the Father, Son. We fall out. All this book. All this book. And we fall out by that. While sin, nature dwells in you, it don't have to rule you. Because a lot of things, we above sin. A lot of things, because we in position and we, you know, passion people, we think we're above falling short. Well, how David got with Bathsheba? We use it when we do wrong. Now, we'll use David when we do wrong, but we don't see David messed up. God said in Philippians 2:5, he said, let that mind be in you, which also in Christ Jesus. But I suffer on his behalf. I'm a contender, not a pretender. See, a lot of preaching we say, we pretend that we holy, and then we ain't a contender for the gospel. But you know, it's a lot of times we don't want to hear nobody. But I love the way when they was on the transfiguration and Peter thought they could make a tabernacle for this and a tabernacle for that. And then all of a sudden, as the shadow came over, the Lord said, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. You know what he told the disciples? Hear ye him. So I know a lot of people don't want to hear me, but he told me to occupy until he returned. He called me to preach his gospel, and I don't care about y'all. He said, hear ye him. If I'm giving you the truth, what can you say? That's why God told me it's a mercy that you go preach the gospel. He said, look, for the time has come. Y'all hear that? That the judgment must begin at the house. So if it begin at us, what we gonna do, y'all? Huh? We need a word from the Lord. God had it for you. What we gonna do if the judgment begin here and all of us living in a kind of way, got anger problem, got jealous in our heart, pride, image, strife, and we love this present world. He said, don't love this world and the things in it. We love the things in it because that's why we can't preach like we should, because we looking for filthy lucre. And he told us, don't preach for filthy lucre. Don't do that. But we miss it because don't nobody know we preaching for. He said, and why I call ye Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say. He said that the judgment must begin at the house of God. Now, ain't that something? And we supposed to be an example trying to get people saved. How people going to get saved when they can't even see the body come together? Y'all tell me that. Everybody come together for us. And y'all know, I believe the church. Y'all don't y'all take it wrong, though. But I'm just telling you how God told me. I believe the church must have been black people for real. Because every race can get along but us. Every race can encourage each other, help each other. They'll have 19 people, 19 families living in one little house with two bedrooms, and everybody got nice cars, and then everybody get a business. But us, when it comes to the church, we got zero understanding of helping each other. And we're supposed to be the body now. But you look at this. Five churches got it open like this. We can slap the devil. If we ever come together and make a fist, we can hit that joker hard. We slapping him, and he laughing at us because he got us separated. He got us separated. And we got the manual. We got the book. When Peyton Manning and Cam Newton get back there, they say they start calling. E46, 32, right. The other team don't know this. We got to call this book on them devil, like what I'm doing right now. 1 Peter 4, huh? And 17. That the judgment must begin at the house of God. I'm calling that place. See, the devil don't know that. See, if the devil had sin, he said, if I be lifted up from the earth, if the devil would have knew, he wouldn't have never lifted him up. If you run these right plays, what the book said. See, Cam Newton is not going to run Peyton Manning play. See, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to run TBN play. TBN line. Y'all keep sending for that holy water. It could come out their bathroom. You really don't know. How they get all that water from Israel? I know y'all don't. Y'all, if y'all buy something, get back. Hand them prayer cloths, all that stuff like that. You know, they got it now. They got them prayer shawl. And now they got a necklace. Now, they ain't have no necklace back then. That lets you know how crooked they is. They going to give you a prayer necklace now. And y'all know some of y'all going to buy it because y'all want to wear it around and act like y'all anointed. The only thing you can lay down and get is flee. You can't get the anointing by somebody else nickel. He said, if it first began at us, if it first began at the church, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? Now y'all know everybody in the church don't obey the gospel, even though we come to church every Sunday. Because in our church, we got some doctors in disobedience. In our church, they got a doctor degree in disobedience. Y'all got it in y'all church? They just ain't gonna obey God. And everybody wanna go to heaven, but don't nobody wanna live right. I don't understand that. This is what it said. He said, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel? Now all y'all sitting here that ain't saved, and all y'all that go to church ain't obeying the gospel, what the end gonna be for you? And the judgment gonna start with us in the, that we supposed to be right. All y'all that started dropping that thing and, you know, working at the, you know, still going to club and still smoking, drinking, home money and all that, what it gonna be for y'all that heard the gospel and didn't do nothing with it? He said, therefore, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. He said, the day that you hear, he said, don't rebel against my word. And we come to church after church after church after church after church like a bad filter system. It's time that the church put up or shut up. It's time for preachers, if we ain't gonna live it, if we ain't gonna live it, stop preaching. Stop leaving it alone. Stop playing with this power for God that we don't think he got no power. He said that obey not the gospel. He said if the righteous is scarcely be saved, if we scarcely be saved, how y'all gonna make it? I'm talking about all of us that trying to tip into heaven. We trying to tip into heaven. See, Jesus got a sense of humor. I know y'all don't know that because y'all preaching on my say. But when you slide home, now Jesus ain't the back catch. He the arm. And we trying to slide into heaven. He gonna say, I don't. You ain't live enough for me, but you wanna slide in home. He out. For all y'all that ain't trying to be right with God, ain't trying to live right. Now I know y'all are saying, I ain't perfect. I ain't said that neither. But I'm mature in the gospel. As I hear, I do. That means I'm becoming perfect. Because as I hear and I get rid of some, in other words, like being pruned. Cut off. Y'all still here? He said, if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinners appear? Where y'all gonna appear that just having life joyful? Doing what you wanna do, when you wanna do it, how you wanna do it. Where life gonna be for you? And I don't care if you live 90, I don't care if you live 120, eternity in hell is longer. That means there ain't no end. Now you can jar, you know, we have good time with our life because we love it. We love it, we love it, we love it. He said, boy, I don't know if this is a sanctified church. Is this a sanctified church? We can't dance over this, can't we? You can't dance over this. Because one thing God said, that word will prick, snick up on you and pull on you. You know, you can act like you ain't hear me, but that word pulling on you. He talking about you. I know. Y'all looking like it ain't talking to y'all, but it pull on you because you said, it's time that the church put up or shut up. And here we are preaching the gospel to somebody we ain't even doing it. That's a bad thing. I don't know, should you call them a false prophet or what? I guess you got to call them a false prophet if they ain't doing it. He said, don't be a heel only. Uh-oh, church. He said, but if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinners appear? He said, wherefore let them that suffer, y'all got that in y'all Bible, according to the will of God, commit the keeping of their soul. That means if I just gone on and commit to God's word, why we won't commit? Why we won't love him like that? Why we won't do him like that? I love to live for 2 and 2. It's that fulfilling ye my joy, that you be like-minded, having the same love, being on one accord and one mind. You know that'll flunk all of us out of him. Because we so caught up in our denomination. It'll kill all us preachers. You read the gospel and you so caught up on what you feel and what you think. And if ain't nobody going your way, you, no. Nah. But then we fellowship with people we don't agree with. How we do that? If we ain't gonna be the body and this and that, and it said, we read it when it said, how can two? We fellowship with people we don't agree with. We fellowship with people that don't even say the same thing we say. But that ain't a problem because we getting that money back. Being on one accord and one mind. Ain't number one book. You can get whatever translation you want. I heard a translation in the morning. The girl read. I ain't never heard in my life. She said, it's a passion translation. So for all y'all that want to be passionate and want God to talk to you passionate, you get a passionate translation. When you go to hell, ain't no passionate. You can get whatever translation you want. You can get whatever preacher you want. We switch churches like it's Burger King. And number one person fits in a burger in the book. And you got to get it all the way. Ain't no hole, no onion. Like y'all want me to hold what I'm saying? Ain't no holding that. Sisters ain't the only one going to jail. I mean hell. Sisters ain't the only one going to hell. Huh? Sisters ain't the only one. We pump on sisters. We ride on sisters. But all of us that's living in darkness. We can preach about sisters all we want, but they ain't the only one going to hell. The whole church, everybody that disobeying the God word, going to hell. It's time that the church put up a shut up. When you say you walking right, you ought to talk right. And I found out that we want to find names that don't really mean enough. My God. I ain't talking about the New Orleans saint. I'm talking about a saint. Do y'all know what saint really mean? It mean holy. And people don't want to be holy, but they say they're a saint. I love God because he make it plain to me. He said in Romans 8:14, he said, for as many as be led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Now, if I was to tell people that I'm not a Christian or I'm not a, I'm a son of God, they'll look at me crazy. If one of y'all talked to me and y'all said, are you a Christian? I said, no, I'm a son of God. Not going against nothing, but I'm the son of God. Y'all look at me crazy. How he the son of God? It just told me. If I walk in the Spirit, if I'm in the Spirit and I'm led by the Spirit, he told me many. But see, that sound too right. I'm a son. I don't deal with all them. I'm a believer. I'm a brother. I just deal with it like that. But y'all know that we don't be born again. We ain't got the Spirit of God. That's our problem. Pastor, how do you know that? How do you know that? How do you really know that? Because Jesus, in Luke 23:34, he started talking about when they were getting ready to crucify him. He was filled. When he got baptized, he ended up getting filled with the Spirit of God. Most of us in the church ain't born again. If you tell me you in the church and you still cuss, I know y'all ain't like that one. I know y'all be trying to say y'all don't know where that come from. No, it's in you. It's in you. Because sweet and bitter water don't come out the same fountain. You can't tell me you talking about blessing, highly favored, and holy and all this, and then you going to slip and talk about, Pastor, why you say that? Because when you filled with the Holy Ghost, you do things that Jesus did. Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them. They said, Hosanna one day, crucify him the next day. He said, but Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And now we don't want to be like that, even though we say we should be like that. We hold hatred in our heart, unforgiveness in our heart. I'm talking to from the preacher all the way to the door. We don't even know how to go to nobody and say, forgive me, Pastor Ed. Forgive me. We don't want to go say the forgiveness because we the man, the woman of God. We don't want to say, so don't you know where that puts you at? If you don't forgive, he won't forgive you. So you walk around with all in your heart. I'm talking about we messed up. We all messed up. But we preaching the gospel to somebody. But he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Stephen come back in Acts 7:60. He said, lay not this sin to their charge. He see what his big brother did. He said, lay not that sin to their charge. When they were Paul was getting ready to stone him, he looked up in the sky and seen the big brother stand him and said, but I don't like what they doing to you. He said, that's all right, Jesus. I'm going to suffer for your name's sake. Don't lay it to their charge. Have you ever said, don't lay something to somebody's charge? I'm talking about a church. They're all are saving, ain't it? We still married with an old girlfriend, old boyfriend. Somebody's tucked your woman. We still married. Somebody owe you $40, $50. We still married with it. And God still bless you. He come back in 2 Timothy 4:16. Paul, the writer, he said, it may not be laid to their charge. He said, Alexander Coppersmith did me much harm. He said, and no man stood with me. But Christ stood up in me. Ain't that something? I know how y'all live. What happened to us supposed to be seeking to save them that are lost? What happened to us supposed to be going outside these doors trying to get people saved? What happened, church? Where it going? I see Muslims out there selling paper by themselves with their bone. They ain't selling bean pie no more. I ain't seen no bean pie, but they still out there selling their paper. We can't get outside the door for nothing. And we need to put that thing up when we talk about past. It's time for the church to put up a shut up. Amen. I hear preachers always saying, you know, it's for the members to go out and get sheep. Because sheep begets sheep. I ain't found that in the scripture yet. We just don't got lazy as pastors. We don't got lazy. That's our problem. We don't think we're supposed to do nothing but receive a check. Don't say nothing about me because I don't get paid. Don't even say nothing about me. Well, you get paid too. No, sir. I don't. I ain't tell you I ain't waiting on it, but I don't. Y'all like that then? See there, I know how to get y'all. I said, I know what y'all said just then. See there? He wants some money too. I know what y'all said. But let me help y'all. Colossians 3:25 says, but he that do wrong shall receive for the wrong which he has done. Ain't nobody exempt there. If you doing wrong, I like to read it from the book. I like to read from the book because, you know, some of y'all can quote it off y'all brain, but it ain't in your heart. I like, he said, hide it in your heart that you won't sin against. See, y'all, we just quote good, but we sin against it. I ain't trying to sin against it. That's why I like to stay with it so I can say it right. That's Colossians 3:25, and some of y'all want to get it. But he that doeth wrong shall receive for the wrongness which he has done. And there is no respect of a person. It don't matter if you're an apostle all the way down to the church. If you're doing wrong, you're going to get judged for your wrong. If you ain't leading right, you're going to get judged for it. That's why I walk a thin line. I'm going to walk like I'm walking on a tightrope with the word. Lord, you know that I ain't as swift as I used to be. But all of my stuff. Huh? Y'all look at it. And we caught up with so many different spirits because we looking for somebody to appease, to say what we want. And so many times we're caught with stuff. We here. Because of traditional taught, being taught, the tradition. But I don't care what you is. I'm going to stay with the scripture. And 1 John 4:1, he said, beloved, it's time for the church to put up a shut up. He said, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit. I don't care if you baptized in Jesus or you baptized in the Father, Son, Holy Ghost. I'm trying the spirit. I don't care how you dress, what you carry, how big your Bible, what you ride in, what title you got, how many doctor degrees you got. It don't really matter. He said, by their fruit, if you walking crooked, you talking crooked, you eyeballing women, you can't call a skunk a cat. Can't do it. You got a pen on them? I'll take it. He said, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit, whether they be of God. I got to try your spirit to see whether you're of God. Conversation don't get it, because the devil know the word of God. Then you see what he did to Jesus when he said, if you be the Son of God, turn these bread into stone. He started talking scripture. Y'all know he quoted some scripture to him. He said, cast yourself down, and his angel got charge over you. He was quoting the scripture with him. He was trying to tell him, go on and do something. Have the devil ever quoted something to you and made it seem right? Like, in other words, you ain't married, and he tell you, you know God made a man for you. You know it's wrong, but you know it sounds, you know, because you want to, you know, we want to, you know, y'all know sign language, right? Just like a, you don't want to, you know. But I'm saying, he encouraged you. Everything, you better than you used to be. If you just do one thing wrong, it's all right. Because you know you can ask for forgiveness. Church don't even you repent no more. Why don't you repent no more? Because they take the easy way out. If I had a motel room for 4 Fridays, and I went to one on 1 Friday, and I went to church Sunday, and I asked for forgiveness on the one. How many more I got? But if I repent, I ain't going back to the 3. Because I'm through with it. But if I want to keep going, I'm going to just ask God for forgiveness right there and feel all right about it. And then I'm going back next Friday. We ain't got none of them in the house. He said, humble yourself therefore in the mighty hands of God, that he might exalt you in due time. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, vigilant, as your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walking about seeking who he devour. Every time you look around, the devil's sliding right up on you. He's trying to get you every time. But you know y'all ain't his. He ain't bothering y'all. What are you going to come and say with his own people for? He ain't got to do it. Ephesians 4th chapter. Talking about unity in the spirit. Tell him all right. He said in Ephesians 4:1, he said, I therefore, Paul taught, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you, intrigue you, I beg you. Paul said, I'm begging the Ephesian church. You that you walk worthy of the vocation of your calling. Huh? Yeah. Wherewith you are called. He said, walk worthy with all lowliness, meekness, and with long suffering, forbearing one another. In love. Huh? Endeavoring to keep the unity. And here we are, boy, ain't trying to keep no unity. I'm talking to preachers now. Because the members can't do this. You know it's bad for you to tell your member they can't go to no other church. Mine can go anywhere they want to go because I have taught them. You know when it's a fishbone, don't eat it. But if you're scared you're going to lose a member, that's not the way God told it. He said, don't be inhabited of my, don't be lord of my inheritance. They ain't our people. Our job is to prepare the people. Ain't no use of being scared because when they get ready to go, they going. You ain't going to be able to stop them. Man, no, you ain't going to be able to stop them. Look what he said. He said, in the unity of the spirit, in the bond of peace. He said, there's one body. Now, why are we confused by that? It's time to put up a shut up. It's only one body. The whole church system ought to come together. We, every church in here ought to be saying, man, you know what? He right. It's time for to put up a shut up. Because we'll get up here and say the body what the body should do. And ain't none of us trying to do it. I don't heard that ever since I got saved. Everybody talking about what the body should do. And then as soon as you invite somebody to your church, they say, I had to tell them it's Super Bowl Sunday. I'm talking about church people. Why I got to tell you it's Super Bowl Sunday before you can accept the engagement? But I love the Lord. He said, there's one body and one spirit. How the church mix up? One body, one spirit. Either you ain't got it or they ain't got it. So who wrong? Who's trying to bridge this gap between the church? Or we just going to stay in our building and say, okay. There's one body and one spirit, even as you are called in one hope of your calling. One Lord. And we all messed up. You know one thing God told me when I accepted the calling of apostle? He told me first thing, Apostle Simba, denounce your pastorship. And y'all know how we try to hold on to stuff, but we said we apostles. But he told me I denounced that. I said, man, come on, God. He said, yeah. Because you're going to be an apostle, you can't walk under no just no name or no church. I gave every robe I had with Cornerstone away. He said, you can't do it. Then he said, how are you going to be an apostle when you ain't in out of no other churches? How you going to know what to preach about? How you going to know it correct when you ain't there? This is what he talked to me about. This is what he told me. And some people try to get me to get laid hands on. He told me, apostle don't get hand laid on. This ain't from man. This from God. And I'm trying to do everything I can to do what he tell me. I don't really care how nobody feel about me. I don't care if I don't preach nowhere. It don't really matter. I preach enough. Every day I preach. Every day I'm before the Lord. I don't sit around and just wait on the God to come to me. I don't bother him. He bother me. Amen. Y'all done got serious. Now I must have talked about something I shouldn't. I must have talked about something I shouldn't. But, you know, that's what I do. is that there is one body and one spirit, even as you are called into one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, and one baptism. How we get all that messed up? Why the body can't come together? Why? One God, one Father of all, so it ain't no mixed up. Huh? Because he ain't did no knocking everybody off trying to get no children. He just made all. He said, who is above all and through all and in all. He said, but unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore, he said, and people try to tell me, ain't none of that happening now. Until God put a cover on the old man, we'll keep doing what we're doing. We ain't gonna change. Know why another thing why we so messed up? It's just like when Jesus went in the temple, 12 years old. They was astonished by him, but because he was so young, didn't nobody want to hear him. And because I don't came on the scene late, don't nobody really want to hear me. They don't want to hear me. But I promise you, when it comes to this book, I stay with it. Precept upon precept, line upon line. I ain't got time to be arguing with how you feel about this and what you think about this. This is what he said in 1 Corinthians 12. I'm getting y'all to the Super Bowl. He said in 1 Corinthians 12 and 12. He said, for as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. If Christ want to be the head of the church, why the body of Christ can't come together? It's time to put up a shut up. It's time to put up. Why are we looking like that, y'all? It's the book. Why are we looking like that? Let me go back and say it. Let me go back and say this. Because I know y'all. If you say someone should put up a shut up, you mean that they should either take action in order to do what they have been talking about. So I'm just telling y'all to do what y'all been talking about. In other words, it said, put one money where your mouth is. I ain't gonna say nothing. I don't believe in that book. And I don't care. I don't care if the enemy wanna kill me. He can't kill me. Let God allow him to. You can't shut my mouth because I ain't got to do nothing. I'm a preacher regardless. I've been called to do this. I don't care. I love it too. I'm so excited about it. You can come in the church. The people tell you I'm the same way all the time. Check my sons and when you get ready. I live like that at home. Trina number is 377-9451. Call and ask the dude. Is he really saying like that? Do he really love God like that? See, some of y'all can't call y'all wife. You can't call y'all wife because y'all wife said, no, it ain't the same person now. Huh? Unless they're going to go to hell for them. My wife, what you say, Pastor, somebody? You crazy, man. Lord, I am. Listen to what he said. Let me come on down here right here. He said, for by one spirit are we all baptized into one body. See, the baptism of water is one thing, but the baptism of spirit is another. You can't separate them. We can baptize any kind of way we want to, but when you talk about the spirit, that's only one. That's what I'm talking about. I got the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost ain't. You know how y'all, I thought everybody had it. Everybody run around the church. I'm like, boy, when I'm going to get hit with that? I'm like, they're speaking the tongue. Hyundai, Kandai, Pwana, Katai, Wanda, Bwana, Bwana, Bwaza. I'm like, dog, when I'm going to get some of that? You know, but I found out it wasn't in there. I found out it was in me. Serious, taking the word and stand on it. Which one is most saved? The one speaking? The one dancing? Because all you got to do is let the music stop. Ella, what time it is, Ella? It said, for by one spirit are we all baptized into one body. Whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be born or free, and having all made to drink into one spirit. Every church out should be drinking out of one spirit. Now, either you're going to drink out the devil, because that's the only option. And y'all know the Bible talks about the children of God gonna manifest itself, the children of the devil. I believe in Rev 9, 2016, because the church saying, give me a lie rather than give me the truth. The church want to be lied to. Y'all want to be prophesied. Give me $100 and you can be debt free. And you don't get about $1,000 and you ain't debt free yet. Stop giving them people your $100 and get saved. They can't buy their way in here. They can try to get some money here and think they're going to get close to me. They're going to better get close to the Lord. He said, for the body, it's not one member, but many. If the foot shall say, because he is not the hand, am I not the body? I wish my foot was start talking about he ain't the part of the body because he the foot. Boy, you better walk when their brain said move. That's the way the body of Christ should be. When the head said move, this body ought to move. When the head said change your different, we ought to change our different. When the head said body come together, we ought to come together. We ought to stop sitting around talking about, well, I really don't want to fellowship with them. You know, a lot of us don't want to fellowship because we ain't got number two or three members. I wouldn't care how many members got. You're a part of the body, you can have one member. You still a part of me. Even if a part of your body handicapped, I take that too. He said, if the foot shall say, because I am not the hand, I am not of the body. It is therefore not of the body. He asked a question. Paul asked him a question. Well, how y'all get caught up with this? And then here we come with the best example, and we come back and get caught with the same thing. Yeah. And we got the Spirit of God dwelling in us now. We're supposed to have it going strap on. We got the Old Testament and the New Testament. And then people going to tell me the black Israelite, the black Israelite want to tell me we missing 12 books. We can't even do nothing with the 66. What are we going to do with 12 more books? Somebody answer that for me. You don't hardly read the 66. 12 more, you'll lead the church. Y'all know y'all will. How many of y'all read the Bible every day? See how it is here? How many pray every day? See, this is our weapon. The prayer is the most powerful thing that we got. I'm going to help some of y'all. A lot of y'all be praying, they don't go nowhere. But God here is not a sinner prayer. Some of y'all prayer is still up at the ceiling. And I know how y'all think it get answered. Because if you ask for $200 and then Joe Brain $200 by, you know, you said, boy, God heard my prayer. Now the devil trying to keep you from being saved. He kind of crafty, y'all. He got good trick. Then what he said? He said, if the ear shall say, because I'm not the eye, I am not the body. Well, what am I going to do when I can't hear what nobody telling me? How we get rid of that? You can put me anywhere in the body you want to, just put me with the body. That one thing I do, when I do hear preacher, he stayed with the word, I kind of, you know, be like I kind of be, boy, I'm so glad you stay in the word, but I guess these preachers, I don't know, y'all, I don't want to send them, but let me talk to them. No, that was wrong with the church now, we won't talk to them. We preach this gospel. If a jackass were preaching, you ought to be able to say amen or say something. Say something to make me know that you're in agreement. How do we sit in the church and don't say nothing? I'm talking about preaching. Somebody that loves the Lord. Somebody that preaches God. How do we do that? And then when somebody ain't paying you no attention, you want somebody to look at you. I don't understand that. I ain't mad with y'all, though. I've been around this thing a while now. I used to be young in it. You know, I experienced some things. You know, young, zillion man coming in the church. And I used to come in there straight from the freaking center with my little jerseys on and stuff like that. And I broke up in the church one night. And first lady pulled me to the side. She said, baby, come here. She said, now you been in the church a little while. I'm like, yes, ma'am. You know, because, you know, I'm ready. She said, baby, you got to put them guns up. She said, now was all right when you first were coming to the church. She said, but you got to put some on them arms. And you know, you all swole up. You know, everybody here, you know. I said, yes, ma'am. I had on some sweats from then on. See, but now in the church, you can't say none of y'all members. Because half of y'all don't want to live right anyway. I wanted to get this thing right. If they told me something that I was doing wrong and I was in error, hey. Now you got to walk on thin ice with your member. But not up in here. I tell them it's two X's, it's three X's over here, two over there, and then you ain't got to give me nothing, keep going. No, you ain't got to write me nothing. They ain't got to call me, warn me, you leave me. And I should be glad you're gone, because if you would have been us, you never would have left. He said, and if the whole body was the eye, where would the hearing be? And if the whole was hearing, where would smelling be? Boy, y'all know I got to smell something. I already don't smell that good. That's why I'm glad I got a body. And I'm glad I got a wife, because we won. She said, baby, did you smell that? I'm like, no, because she know I throw up if I smell something too bad. But sometimes I don't smell it. I'm glad, but she smelled it. So then I shut up. See what I'm saying? Y'all didn't get that in. Sin stinks in God's nostrils. He don't shut up like that. It just stinks in my nostrils, but I shut up because I don't want to smell it. God don't shut up. I need you. You need me. We need each other. I'm going to let y'all go. I'm coming to a close right now. Is that time? Oh, well, I got two more quarters, man. Hey, look at him. Boy, I'm so glad. Boy, you won't help me there. So many times we are confused. Can I help y'all? I'm talking about help the whole church. I'm going to help y'all with the word. So many times we got our way of saying how people going to go to heaven. And if you ain't this way, and you ain't that way, you ain't going to make it in. Right? And for so long I heard the holiness church say the baptism was messed up until I got to know God's word. Holiness is messed up too. For real now. Now, Baptists do work together and they do share and help each other. Holy won't help each other. And we supposed to be, we got the Spirit of God, right? But we try to tell each other why we ain't going to heaven. But if we stay with the book, it ain't no man can tell you how you go but Amen. The book. Turn with me to Psalm 15. Because the church need to put up a shut up. We need to stop giving people false words and false hope and who going, why you ain't going, this one ain't going, that one ain't going. I'm so glad that Jesus died and he ain't let none of y'all die for me. And then he ain't let none of y'all have mercy and grace for me, because I know y'all been to put me in hell. I know I already been gone. That's why I'm glad he died for me. So I ain't got the answer to none of y'all and I ain't on none of y'all payroll. But you need to put up a shut up. And y'all can tell me that too if I'm wrong. But preaching the gospel that we're not doing, we need to stop talking. And all us going on the job, talking about I'm blessed and highly favored in the morning, then cussing later on in church service when your boss don't told you to do something. We killing the church. We killing what God playing there. And people try to tell you, well, if you wear earrings, you can't go to heaven. If you wear a short dress, you can't go to heaven. You know all this stuff. If you put weed in your hair, you can't go to heaven. You got all kind of stuff. They, you know, I'm just saying. Why y'all, what's wrong with y'all? But we went to a church and the dude told, got up and was talking. And that's why I say y'all to put up a shut up. He said, these women in here got earrings on and makeup on and all that. And we all not to be like that. And, you know, my sister had just died. And I went over to the mobile and he got up and started talking. I'm like, man, they let me talk. And I said, I ain't come all the way over here. And my sister just died for to hear somebody, my wife wear earring and makeup. So y'all know how I am. And I don't care about being over in Mobile. I'm going to put up or shut up. So I told him, if you want your wife looking ugly, yeah, man, that's touchdown, lady. It's all right to laugh. My wife fixed herself up. If you want your wife to look dry and all like that, that's you. I ain't mad with you. I love my wife looking good. I tell her, baby, take some money, go get you some outfit. You ain't got to ask me nothing. You know, some of y'all wife had to ask y'all something. My wife don't have me nothing. We won. She can make good decisions. Let me get to this because y'all about ready to go. In the division of Psalm 15:1, it said, Lord, who shall abide in our tabernacle? In this scripture I preach over there, who shall dwell in our holy hill? He that walketh upright. It didn't say nothing about what I was baptized in. It didn't say nothing about my dress size. It didn't say nothing about no earring. It ain't said nothing about no makeup. I'm just talking about the word. And that's why I said we ought to put up a shut up. And that's why God said, hear ye him. That's why God told me, he tell me a lot of things. He said, thou son of man, I have set thee a watchman over the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them. He said, warn them. So he said, he that walketh uprightly, worketh righteousness, speak the truth in his heart. He that backbite not with his tongue, not do evil to his neighbor, not take a reproach against his neighbor. David asked the question, who shall make it? Who? Who gonna make it to heaven? That gave me some direction right there. Terry, you can do whatever you want to, but you ain't walking upright. You ain't doing what God said. Then he come back and David said again in the vision of Psalm 24. He said, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, and the world and they that dwell therein. For he has founded upon the sea and established upon the flood. He said, who shall ascend into our hills, O Lord? David, why are you asking that again?
Glory.
Why? Because God got something else to tell him. He's telling, he said, who shall ascend into the hills of the Lord? Or who shall stand in the holy place? Y'all see that? He that has clean hands, a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sword deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and the righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek his faith.
Glory.
It ain't much to say. Apostle Terry Simmel, you have won the Super Bowl. He said, they couldn't stop you. You're the best QB. You had the best running play. But you had the best defense. The enemy didn't get a chance to score. I did not let him score. And I love him. But he said, a man that wonders out of the way of understanding, get away from this book. He said, don't add, don't take away. Don't say what you feel. Don't say what you think. And as I close, in Ecclesiastes 12:13, Solomon, the preacher. He said in 7 verse, he said, then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. But the 13th verse, he said, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. It's time for the church to put up or shut up.